Our next presenter is Professor Takashi Shimizu, University of Tokyo. Please, Takashi.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Takashi Shimizu from the University of Tokyo. And thank you, first of all, thank you so much for inviting me to this interesting, really meaningful conference. I really got excited to when I got the invitation, but actually saw the program, I was feeling a bit unlucky because my presentation was placed just before the dinner. So every day I can hear the silent voice, please make it short, make it short. So okay, I'll try to make it short, as short as possible. My presentation is about so-called zybots. Actually, Professor Kyung-dong Kim mentioned about this name, so it's rather easier for me to talk about. But my plan is basically I will talk about a strange fact about zybots, Japanese zybots, and its implication to the study of Asian capitalism. But before that, let me explain a bit about the idea behind my research. My basic idea is to investigate the relationship between organizational forms, such as corporations, partnerships, limited partnerships, LLCs, blah, blah, and the development of Asian capitalism. what was the role of organizational forms in the developmental process of Asian capitalism? Why? Some people may think that organizational forms such as corporate form, partnership form, is not so meaningful. But in fact, some scholars discussed that organizational forms are somewhat important in the process of economic development. Like corporate form in the 19th century US, or private, so-called GmbH or SAR, in France, Germany and France in late 19th century and early 20th century, or LLCs in the United States. And of course we know that some Asian countries achieved high economic growth. So it's a kind of natural question to think about the relationship between organization forms and development of Asian economies. Especially this question is interesting because corporate laws in those countries are basically transplanted from Western countries to those Asian countries, from UK, Germany, France, the Netherlands, and the US, or some other countries. So how the Asian countries, use this imported or transplanted organizational forms for in the process of economic development? And this time, I'd like to focus on so-called family groups. Family groups or family businesses are basically interesting, and there's a paper about this point. And we know that family groups is a kind of characteristics of Asian countries. And family groups here means that there's the group in which there are several companies in several different areas, and those countries are owned and controlled by one headquarter company, holding company. And Zaibatsu, Japanese Zaibatsu is one example, and of course Chevron's another example. So, and why Japan? Actually, this is the point. because one point is that Japanese Zaibatsu are one of the earliest examples of in East Asia. But another thing, this is more important, Japanese Zaibatsu used general partnerships or limited partnerships for their holding companies. It's kind of strange. As far as I know, at present, we cannot see such examples, at least in East Asian countries. All the Chaebols recently started to establish their own holding companies, but as far as I know, all of those holding companies were established as corporations, just ever. So it's a bit strange for them to use partnership or limited partnerships the headquarters. Of course, we can find some examples. In the late 19th or early 20th century Europe, investment banks, including such as Rothschild, Warburg, or some other investment banks were organized as partnership, or in some cases, limited partnerships. But still, we can ask that why Japanese daimyos used those partnerships or limited partnerships for their headquarters. Okay, let me, and this is really strange. I'll explain a bit about how strange it is. Before World War II, there are several forms in Japan. Corporate form, partnership, limited partnership, blah, blah, blah. And basically, corporations, the corporate form was for large organizations, and limited partnership, basically rather smaller organizations. Let me show you one. You can see that average size of indicating the average amount of capital of corporations, limited partnerships, and partnerships. Then we can easily understand that corporations are much bigger than limited partnerships and partnerships. And the other interesting characteristic is that so manufacturing sector, there are many corporations and not so many limited partnerships or partnerships. And size is rather small. But as for in commerce, I mean commercial companies, you can see many rather big limited partnerships and partnerships. So basically, as I just said, the corporate form is large organizations, and in manufacturing sectors, many companies are using corporate form, and in commercial sectors, many companies are using limited partnership or partnerships. And as for, according to the statistics in Tokyo City, in 1936, there were 151 big companies, and among those, only one company, it was a limited partnership. And there are seven partnerships. But Zaibatsu headquarters are really a kind of exceptions. Zaibatsu, I mentioned this, so a group of companies controlled on and owned by members of specific family and the holding company there. Maybe some of you have heard about Mitsui or Mitsubishi or Sumitomo. And those are basically Zaibatsu were dismantled after the World War II. And Professor Kendo Kim mentioned this process was stopped. But actually, yes, that's true. But big Zaibatsu were actually dismantled and headquarters are actually dissolved. But we can see the ex-member companies, and even now, like Mitsubishi Heavy Industries or Mitsubishi Car Company, something like that. But basically, Zaibatsu headquarters were dissolved just after the World War II. Or like, something like this. I included some photos or figures just to wake you up. So this is the headquarters, and it's controlling many companies. And it's also Mitsubishi's case. The situation structure is very similar. And you can imagine the situation. And as I mentioned, in Tokyo City, about 150 big companies, and there was only, among them, only one company was limited partnership. What is this company? When we check that some company almanacs, then we can find that this company is the headquarters of Mitsubishi Zaibatsu, one of the biggest Zaibatsu. The amount of capital was 120 million yen. Okay, let me go back. The average size amount of capital of limited partnerships is about 60,000. The capital of Mitsubishi headquarters was 120 million. It's about 2,000 times larger than the average limited partnerships. So it's really, really exceptional in the sense that it's a really big company, but it's still organized as a partnership, general partnership. Oh, this is headquarters. It's also using the red brick building. So this is rather, you know, also unusual for in this time in Japan. It's just located in front of Tokyo Station. And other big companies there, according to the city of, in city of Tokyo, there are two big partnerships, general partnerships in commercial sectors. And we can find that one of them is so-called Mitsui, the headquarters of Mitsui Zaibatsu. Mitsui is another big Zaibatsu. Its amount of capital is about 300 million. It's about 1,500 times larger than the average partnership. So now you can understand the situation. Those Zaibatsu headquarters companies are really big, but they're using partnership or limited partnerships, which are basically used by small and medium sized enterprises. So the next question is why? Oh, this is the headquarters Mitsui. You can see this in Tokyo, in Nihonbashi area. So actually, it's not unusual for Zaibatsu. Well, let me show you one. Okay. Not only Mitsui, but also some other big Zaibatsu. I named 11 big Zaibatsu here. Actually, it was 15, but four are operating companies, so I excluded. Among 11 biggest Zaibatsu, five are using general partnerships, and two are using limited partnership, and only four are using corporate form, the corporate form. And as among those corporate four companies which are using corporate form, two are actually new ones. Let me go back to the list. If you take a look at the year of establishment, many companies' headquarters are established before the 1920s, but the newest one is that there are two newest ones, Riken and Nissan. And those are called new Zaibatsu, new concerns, because the structure is really different. Nissan was established by one person called Yoshisuke Aikawa. Aikawa is the correct name, actually. And headquarters is Nippon Sangyo, was public corporation. Actually, it's, the stock was sold to the general public, unlike other Zaibatsu headquarters. And Riken is also interesting. Riken was established by one research institute, Rikaga Kenkyujo, Institute of Science and Chemical Research. And actually, this institute wanted to have much more money for research. And so that it established a new company to make money. It was established Rikaga Kogyo in 1927. And those two, I mean, research institute and Rikaga Kogyo, formed a group called Riken Sangyodan, Riken Industrial Group. So now you can understand the situation. I mean, many companies are using general partnerships, and some are using limited partnerships, and not so many were using the corporate form. And why is that so? As for Mitsui, I checked the history of Mitsui, and I found that Mitsui borrowed this idea from Rothschild and some others, Warburg. Warburg is now merged into UBS, and UBS Warburg was there. And the purpose was to keep that Mitsui headquarters a family-owned private company. And but one unresolved question is that, but they could do that by using a closely held corporation. I mean, they can do that by using the corporate form. And another interesting thing is Sumitomo. When Sumitomo established a limited partnership, and there, when it was established, there are four general partners. One is the head of owner family, Mr. Tomohito Sumitomo. But other three, the other three general partners were not from owner family. Actually, they are salaried managers, high-ranked salaried managers. Mr. Yukawa, Mr. Nakata, and Mr. Suzuki, all of them are known high-ranked salary managers. So, and those four had a kind of light of vote about the final decision-making. So how about other members of owner family? Actually, they are selected as limited partners. And according to the commercial code at that time, limited partners didn't have a right to vote. So Sumitomo, Mr. Sumitomo excluded their family members and invited salaried managers for the limited partnership. And they had a right to vote to make the final decision. So salaried managers were officially involved in the decision-making process, and its situation is often called the sovereign lands, but doesn't rule that situation. So it means Mitsubishi, as for Mitsubishi, one of the biggest drivers, it's a kind of exception. Because for some reason, I don't know, the old commercial code was established made in 1893, yes, at the same time. And at that time, partners of limited partnerships, all of the partners of a limited partnership can be limited partners, could be limited partnership. It's strange. But usually, regarding one limited partnership, we need one limited partnership and one unlimited partner. But for some reasons, there's no such a regulation. So in 1989, it changed. But Mitsubishi was established before that, so it didn't change the structure. So it's a kind of exception. In fact, the Mitsui is to secure the involvement of Mitsui family, and Mitsui and Sumitomo is established joint management, as Sumitomo is. And why? Again, why? Probably one reason is not the they didn't use the corporate form is to secure the commitment. If a person from the owner family became unlimited partners, then it can they could show their commitment to the company. At that time, like in the England in 19th century, people didn't trust so much corporate form because all of the shareholders had limited liability. So in order to escape such a situation and to secure the commitment, they use the partnership form or limited partnership form because they wanted to show their commitment to the management. Let me go back to the current world. So one problem is that, as I said, in East Asia, as far as we know, there's no such holding companies of a family group which are using the partnership form or the limited partnership form. But I found one example in Thailand. In Thailand, there is a kind of investment company owned by a specific family. And this company is owned shares of a group called CP Group. But I found this is the only example. And actually, this limited partnership is not a controlling company. It's just investment and do investment and try to keep the asset of the family. When we think about the commitment problem, somehow we need a commitment of a owner family to the management of a family group. If they didn't commit, they don't commit, then we cannot trust those families. Well, we cannot trust those companies. So in order to do transactions, or in order to do business with the family group, then we need a kind of device to secure the commitment to the management. There may be similar other kinds of commitment devices to show the commitment. Maybe invest the past money, giving guarantee, or strong ties, or something like that. Maybe in Japan, one idea to show the commitment is to provide a personal guarantee. A CEO or president often provide a personal guarantee to the debt of a company, the company, not the personal debt. But also in China, we don't think about so much, we don't have to think so much about this because it's there. Many big companies, state-owned, community-owned, but maybe in some cases, especially in private companies, we have to think about how the family can show the commitment. And as for Korea, I'm a bit unsure about that. Maybe one idea is establish a strong tie between owner family and employers or other stakeholders. This is a specialization. This is not my specialization, Dr. Kim's specialization, but if we think about the Daewoo case, then there was what called Daewoo family, Daewoo Kajuk. It's something interesting to show the commitment of family to their employees. So maybe this is one topic to think about the family groups in East Asian countries. How we can, or how they can show their commitment to the management so that they can be, can be trusted by stakeholders or other, or maybe employees or other stakeholders. Okay, I'll stop here and thank you so much for the attention.